This is Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
Okay, I'm going to try this again. I'm going to enter Markarth for a second time, but during the day, so that the NPCs are at their marks when I come into the place, instead of wherever they were in the last video. Half of them weren't where they're supposed to be. Bit of jewelry for your journey home. Oh, this time I'm just gonna let him kill her. Okay. I'm just gonna stand here. Be passive. Passive aggressive. Wow, he's still alive. Where are the guards?
I die for my people.
What are you looking at?
Oh, here comes a guard. I guess they were spawning from uphill.
Gods. A woman attacked right on the streets. Are you alright? Did you see what happened?
Yeah. I was right there.
You don't have to say sorry.
I must have missed it.
Oh, I think you dropped this. Some kind of note. Looks important.
Since he's gonna lie to me, I'm gonna lie to him. But we both know we're both lying.
We'll handle things from here. Move along. Until next.
Margaret, he killed her. Right in front of me. I'm sorry. I don't think I can bear to sell anything right now.
Did you see that, madman? A forsworn agent, here in the city.
This has ruined my entire day.
What can I do for you?
Lucien, you don't know about this stuff? Maybe he will later. Away we go! Maybe he'll know about the forsworn conspiracy. In the next installment of Lucien.
All right, then.
151, 152, maybe?
What? Did you need something? All right, I'll take care of it.
So this is the wench I rescued from the Four Corners or something like that. The Four Skulls, Ruin, something, anyway. That was an ordeal. That happened like 2 videos ago.
Better get going.
It has plenty of strong drink and clean rooms.
Oh, come on, Klepper, get over here. Gah. What are you doing? Who idles over there?
You a fighting man? How about a little bet? I'm drunk, and it's been a while since I had a good fight. 100 septims says I can take you. Barehanded. That's the spirit. Let's go.
Who touched my helmet? Keep those hands up!
This is an old friend.
Get up. You're not hurt.
Wait. I can still fight. No, I can't.
we're both in
fair
agony.
Fight. Here you are.
My father, Klepper, is the one you want to talk to. I just clean up.
Around this point is when I removed the head tracking I was using. It works pretty good.
Unlike my husband Klepper, I watch after hours.
It had its purpose. It served its purpose.
What was that you say, the venomous wife of mine?
Nothing, you pig-headed oaf.
But I wanted to
Oh, did you need something?
Try some mods that the head tracking could get in the way of. Like, get rid of face-to-face and put in conversation camera. Conversation piece for cameras. I don't know what it's called.
What can I do for you?
Yet another backport of a mod. Whenever you see a mod that says LE at the end of it, that usually means it came from SE.
I understand. It's an end to the evil. Until next time. Foes.
Beware, beware. There's some other mods I want to install.
For the darkness has passed, and the legend. Don't mind the yelling. My parents are always going at each other. I'd better get going. Dragonborns
come. This is the Silverblood Inn. I'll let you figure out who owns it by yourself. Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
Yes, there's a mod out there that makes dragons ginormous. So sure. I want to give that one a try.
I'll show you to your room. Right.
Makes dragons. I want to say that makes them like 4 times bigger. It's just a skeleton resize kind of thing. I don't think it has any mesh changes at all. It doesn't alter where you sit. You still get to sit on the dragon's head. So it's very never-ending story kind of thing.
In Cyrodiil, we respect each other's personal space.
This Lucian 5-0, he's kind of irritating. He stands very close to you.
What do you need, handsome? Huh?
He doesn't know what personal space is.
How can I argue with that?
Whoa, I almost stayed invisible there. Come on, script lag. So what'd I get? Oh, I can't read that. I like the winch that gives me increase in
I'm what you'd call a
carry
soldier
weight.
Of fortune. Make me an offer, and I just might fight at your side.
Oh, you might?
What can an old scout
I'm gonna give you money and you might? Huh? You should rephrase that.
Watch your back, friend. Better yet,
this one's a favorite
to do it for you.
A legend we all know and love. Our hero claims a warrior's heart. I tell you the plan.
Anyway, so I thought I'd go talk to the Jarl.
Any signs of Talos worship, it's your obligation to report them to me.
Yeah, the first thing I notice, there's a slight change in this guy's outfit.
As if this craggy, wretch of a city could be a burden to a superiorly bred mer such as myself. No, I'm not from Markarth. I was sent here to lead the Tholmor's interests in this.
He's got this hood, but he also has the helmet on as well. Isn't that cool?
Until next time.
Was that how it always was? I don't remember. But he's definitely been enhanced by a mod. So he's got like armor. He's got armor underneath his robe. But it's not really a robe, it's more of a cloak. So he's got this cloak over his armor. It's kind of cool.
Alright then.
Man, I don't know if that. I wasn't paying attention.
Tolomar is the commander of the Thornborn.
See, this guy's got a cloak. But that's just Skyrim, you know, cloaks of Skyrim. But the other guy, his cloak looked pretty darn fancy.
Very well. You may approach the mortal throne, but watch your words.
I'm gonna have to go to the editor and see what record is altered just for him.
As his house carl, Igmund's security is my chief concern.
And I reinstalled the Stormcloak battle armor replacer.
Who knows what that family would do for power? They could be working with the Forsworn for all we know.
So that will start showing up in a video soon, I hope. Once the Stormcloak starts to respawn in my game.
Yes, sir.
I took it out when I had clothing clutter fixes installed. I have to make a mental note. Do not install any of Cryptor's mods. don't do it.
I don't know you, and I don't sell.
They do more than advertise. They touch too many records, too many things.
And you prove to be reliable. I might deem you worthy to live here. My steward will handle things from there.
They start to fix things that don't need fixing.
Are you a sellsword? I don't like your kind. No honor, no loyalty. Unreliable, but I can't turn away a potential ally in these times. Let's see.
See, I like how he despises me, but yet he wants me to be an ally still.
Hiding out in their blood-soaked camps. Deal with them. We will see.
And I noticed one thing in Skyrim: when you accept a job, you don't get paid up front. You have to do it first before you get paid. And the person hiring you hopes you die. Isn't that weird? Almost half of the people that hire you for something wish you died. Or don't expect you to ever come back. I'm not using practical armor. What is it called? Practical female armor. So any female armored suits are going to have boobs on them. It's just the nature of the beast. One of these people is from Interesting NPC. Oh, that's the person. That's weird, if you get close to the fire, you can hear the waterfall that's on the other side of this wall. Isn't that weird? You would think that no sound would come through the stone. None. If I remember right, the Jarl's bedroom has a waterfall and a river going right through it? How can you sleep when you have river water running through your bedroom?
Good day.
Missed what they were saying. They were saying something that I barely ever hear in my game. Let's see if this guy stops me.
Halt! The Dwemer Museum isn't open to anyone without the court wizard's permission. Because Kalsilmor doesn't want anyone to go in. He runs the museum. He makes the rules. You have a problem with that? Go talk to him. You'll find him in front of the ruins during the day, just down the tunnel.
it's about the Hall of the Dead. No, you can't go in there. I can't talk about it. Rest assured, the Jarl hears everyone's concerns. You will be able to visit the dead again soon.
And this guy stuck to me again. When I went into the Hall of the Dead, he was... someone to sort this mess out anyway. He was right on my heels.
Some of the dead have been eaten. Flesh has been chewed off.
So I'm probably going into the Hall of the Dead before he's finished talking to me. Anything yet.
It's like it knows when I'm there. If you can get to the bottom of this, the priesthood of Arkay will reward you.
And then it looks very awkward when he's standing there and I'm having a conversation with the invisible cannibal.
Tread lightly in the hall. You don't know what's in there.
See, there he is. He's like, why are you here?
Not many would walk blindly into a crypt smelling of steel and blood. But not fear.
I hate it here.
I feel the hunger inside of you, gnawing at you. You see the dead, and your mouth grows wet. Your stomach growls.
Find out what's happening in the Hall of the Dead. Arkay will watch over you.
It's all right. I will not shun you for what you are.
I thought he was going to leave and go back to his post outside, but no. He's got the hots for somebody in here.
You were young when you first tasted human flesh, weren't you? A brother or sister had died. An accident, of course. Then the hunger set in. Curiosity. What's the harm in just one bite? It's okay now. You found a friend who understands you. You can let go of your guilt. A lot of our kind block out the memory of their first meal. The shame is too much. But you don't need to hide anymore. Namira, the Lady of Decay, accepts you for what you are.
Yeah, I don't remember there being this much fog in here.
We can sate our appetites without judgment.
This is a pretty drafty Hall of the Dead, if you ask me.
It's inside Reachcliff Cave. But the dead have stirred from their slumber recently, and I was forced here. Meet me there. We all fight our way to Namira's embrace together. Until then, tell the people of Markarth that their dead won't be disturbed anymore. We have bigger plans ahead.
So technically, this is the first time I've seen someone invisible, other than the assassin.
You've returned. What happened in the Hall of the Dead?
You were there, you saw.
Divines preserve you. You're a hero.
So this happened in my last playthrough.
Here. Take my amulet as
well. I'm probably just doing something wrong.
All right then.